So good morning all once again. So in today's lecture we'll be deep diving into more technical things of Python programming language. So whatever we have discussed so far was more of basics, only the basics, right? So let me share you the screen. Is the screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Prajit. So in our previous classes, we had discussion on a few very basic things of Python, how few things are common, how to declare a variable. Then we learned about few expressions, the flow control. In flow control, we learned about various Boolean values, possible Boolean values for the functions, the conditional statements, the if, else, elif, and the exit, system.exit functions and inbuilt functions and modules which are available. Right. So in our today's lecture, we'll be going ahead with functions in depth. What functions, how can we create a function? How is it different here in Python compared to other programming languages which you have learned? So basics of functions will have operations. How do we operate in your function? How can we make use of loops or conditional statements here in the functions? We'll see that. So anything that you feel like noting down and can be important from an examination point of view, you can make a note of it. And as I said, as you must have already seen in your Google Classroom, that on the day one, you have to submit your assignments, which is nothing but whatever we have discussed here so far, by the end of this month. Those have to be produced in the form of notes, which will be your assignment one. Okay, so hopefully we'll be starting off the offline colleges from 1st October, but wait for the guidelines, okay? So before me proceeding ahead, can anybody tell me what is a function in basic definition? By now you are already aware of what is function. So your own definition or in your own terms, what do you mean by function? Anybody? You can unmute yourself and you can answer. It's a simple question. What is a function? See, when I'm waiting for you to answer, you can unmute your mic and you can tell me. There's no problem. Not necessarily you have to make use of chat box. Rajiv says block of reusable code. Okay. Omkar says anything that performs specific task. Fine. Anushka says set of instructions to perform specific task. Close enough. Yeah. Anybody else who have any other opinion or want to add to these partial definitions? Yeah, anybody, you can unmute your mic and you can answer it, no problem. Sanket says part of code which is used multiple times. Okay. Which can be used multiple times, you can say. Not necessarily that the part of the code has to be used multiple times, but still, it is a definition, good definition. Anybody else? See, I want others to answer. There are fixed faces who are answering every now and then. I would request others to be interactive. I don't know what is stopping you from interacting. Yeah, please, Yogesh.
Function is a code which runs when it is called.
Function is a code which runs when it is called. Okay, good. But what is the task of the function? You said when it is called, what it does when it called. Good. But what is the whole motive of having a function in your program? It's a simple question, right? And I think you guys are fifth semester guys shouldn't have any problem answering the question, what is function? You have gone through C programming lab, various, I'm not asking function with respect to Python only, function in general. Satvik says, what he says is, A function is a group of code that together performs a task. Okay, good. Vaishnavi says block of code that performs specific action. Okay, so same definitions put up in different words, but accepted. Fine. So most of you have told what is a function, right? So it is exactly what you mean, but you mean the same thing, but you have used different terms to define a function, right? So basically, it's a program in its own. It's a small program in its own, right? Which can perform a specific task, as you said. So let us open our Python IDE itself and create a function, and we'll see how does it operate. So those who are in position with laptop or a PC, you can open your Python IDE and it can perform along with me. No problem if you are using in your mobile phone as well. So let my Python get open. Yeah. So here we have the first screen, that is our interactive shell, right? So let's say I open a new file or new window, and I type the program. So the basic way to declare a function or define a function in Python is by this. You have to make use of the keyword def that denotes define, followed by the name of the function, and the colon denotes that it is the start of the function, right? The function is beginning from here. So let's say I give also, or let's say in order to save some time, what we'll do is we'll have the same program which has been taken here. So those who are doing with along with me, you can, I'll give you time to note this thing down. Those who are not having laptop or PC or mobile, not making use of mobile phone, you can simply make a note of it and make sure that you later implement these programs and save these programs, which will be handy in the later stages when we'll be actually doing the things practically hands-on in our offline classes, right? So here we have the same program here. I'm taking the same example so that you can relate to what the author is trying to say here, right? So as I said, the keyword def ensures that you are defining the function here, followed by the function name, and the colon means the start of the function. Now in that function, in this function, this is my whole function. In this function, what I'm doing is I'm simply printing three lines. I'm simply printing three simple messages, like howdy with a single exclamation mark, howdy with three exclamation mark, or hello there. So let's say we print something else here, right? Or let it be, in order to save time, let's not waste time. What we are doing is we are simply printing three statements. There is nothing, any operations here or nothing specific that we are doing. We are just outputting three print statements. Now, once we have this function closed, I'm calling this function three times. Right? I'm calling this function three times. So anybody who want to guess what can be the output? It is simple program. I would request you to give me answer for this. Those who are putting their attendance now, I would request them to be online on time. Yeah, anybody, let me show you the program once again. Anybody who can tell me what can be the answer or what can be the output for this program before I execute it? It's a simple statement of function, hello function, with a three printf statement or having been called three times.
Those three printf statements will execute three times.
Very well. Sanket also says the output will be three times of the print statement. Anushka says it will print nine statements. Very good. So all of you are right. So when I execute, I press F5. Okay, so I have not saved it. Let me save this file as hello. So I think hello, we already have a file. So let us save the file with what? Author assist. So I'll save this file in a camel case letter with hello. fun dot py. So we are defining a hello function here, and once I execute it, as you have said, those three statements will be printed three times, or in other words, that print total will have 9 statements getting printed, right? So just to give you the difference of how these statements are getting printed, we had three different messages here so that we can make out the difference. So simple, right? It's a very simple program. Now let us change this program, or let's say create a whole new file and modify a bit more to okay, before going into more depth, the reason or the main motive of what this function is doing here is, it is, can anybody tell me what it is doing exactly? I mean, not calling and printing the same function, what is that we are achieving from using this function is what I expecting from you. Can anybody tell me what is how is this function helping us, or what are we achieving by doing this? Yeah. Anushka says by calling three times we can print 9 statements. Okay, so basically we are reducing our effort. We are calling only three times, but we are printing the print statement or the messages in the print statement 9 times. Anybody else? You can unmute your mic and you can interact. Reading the chat box feels like reading the messages, but it will be better if you unmute and answer these questions, so that the class can be called as an interactive class instead of a reading chat. Yeah, it's a simple question. I'll repeat my question again. What is that we are achieving from this function, a simple function? Or how is this function helping us by any means?
No need of writing code again and again.
Okay, good. So what we are doing is, we are avoiding redundancy, right? We are making use of the function to do the same task by, as the Anushka says, we were able to print 9 statements, though in our case the 9 statements were same, hello. But let us say we have a few set of fixed message or a fixed statements that we want to convey to the end user, and we want to make it print. Let's say we want to output 3 messages to the user, but we want it to be done multiple times. So instead of typing those 3 messages for 3 more times, which is in fact making our efforts 9 times, we can make use of a function, and that function can be called only 3 times, and those 3 messages what we want to convey can be put inside that function. So what we are doing is, we are reducing the repeat method, right? We are reducing our we are basically avoiding redundancy, right? Shivu says that to reduce code also, correct? So exactly, if we want to print the same message in our code, that code would look something like this, right? The same output would look something like this. So there are 9 printf statements, and which is simply doing the same task but consuming more code size, you can say, and the code length has been increased, right? So in order to avoid that, the functions comes handy. So it's a simple the simple task what a function does, right? So avoiding duplicacy or redundancy. So now let us move ahead and come to the program, and let's do some kind of modification here so that we can print something productive. Let's say I define in this name function, I'll remove this whole thing, and let's say I pass a parameter to it, right? What I'll do is, I'll pass a parameter to this function hello, and inside this that function I'll print a hello message a hello message to that particular person or that particular name which we are passing. So okay, let us keep this function name. I mean, only this much. And what I'll do is, I'll just call this function. The name, let's say anything. Okay. Okay, another name. So I think you are clear with what will be the output so far, right? Anybody can tell me what can be the output? Yeah. Is the font clear, or should I make the font a little bigger? Guys, please answer. Is the font clear, or should I make the font a little bigger size?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, what? Should I make or should I not?
So make it a bit bigger.
Okay. So I hope, is it clear now?
Yes, sir.
Fine. So anybody, yeah, who can tell me what can be the answer for this?
Hello, Sanket. Hello, Akshata.
Hello, Sanket, and hello, Akshata.
Okay, simple as that. And what if I do like this here then?
It will print hello name.
Okay, and?
It will not print Sankita and Akshata.
Yeah, then what about the value that I'm passing to the function? Yeah, please answer first. These are the simple things. You should quickly answer to that so that we can proceed ahead. Yeah, please notice the change here. If I put this name into single quote, what will be the answer? The print first, as you said, it will be hello name. But what about the actual string that I'm passing to the variable name? Yeah, anybody? Yeah, please respond. I'm waiting for your answer. These are very basic things. If you don't answer these things, I would assume that you have not understood the things. But these are very basic, right? Yeah, anybody? Apart from printing hello name, what will it do? What about the parameter that I'm passing to the function, or the argument that I'm passing to the function?
Two times it will give us hello name.
Two times it will give a?
The print statements.
Two times it will give a print. To the variable name. What about these values? Yeah. Anybody else? See, if you don't answer, I will not come to know whether you are understanding the thing or no. Please answer first.
Maybe it is not taken into consideration only.
Sorry?
Maybe it is not taken into consideration.
It will not taken into consideration. Okay. Though it will not taken into consideration, but still these value will be stored in the name, because this name and this name is different, right? This is just a string that we are printing, and this is the variable name, which is name, which will still have these values. But since we are not printing this variable, these values which you are passing to the parameter, they will also be not be printed. Though they will be stored in the variable, they will not be printed, right? So let me show you this first, or let me instead show the previous one. And as you can see, it prints the name or the value that we are passing as the parameter to the variable name. And once I make this change, and then I execute, it will only give us the output of hello name, as you said, two times, because the hello function will be called two times, and the printf statement will give the output two times, but nowhere the values will be assigned, right? No way these value, though it will be assigned to the variable name, but they will not be printed. So simple as that. So let's move ahead and understand how these values basically return these values. How do we set these values and how do we get the return value? So by default, the Python function, so here, okay, so return values, as you must have already seen in our previous programs, we have been making use of the length function, right? LEN, length function, which gives you the length of a particular string that you are passing as the parameter or argument, right? So it will give you the return value of that function. So return statement, as the keyword, it should have the keyword return, the value of the expression that function should return. And to define, to demonstrate that, let us have another program which will actually demonstrate what we have done in our previous classes also, right? Let me quickly, instead of typing everything, I'll save some time and execute these things as it is. So those who don't have the Python IDE, those who don't, those who are not using on the laptop or PC, you can make note of this. You can type this write this program. Others, those who are doing along with me, well and good. If you're facing any problem, please let me know so that we can stop and address your problem first, so that we are on the same page. Right, so what we are doing here is we are going to simply call a random function. We are going to import a random library. This is the standard library or module, what we discussed in our previous class, right? And we are making use of the functions which the random module provides us, which was, as we discussed in the previous class, the randint function, right? So we are importing a random module. We are defining a function called getAnswer. GetAnswer is the name of the function, and the parameter that we are passing to the function GetAnswer is answer number. Okay, please note the keyword here is answer number. So in this function, in this whole function, what we'll be doing is we are simply constructing a set of if-else statements, and we are checking for a few numbers. These numbers are basically will be generated by this random function, randint function, right? And we are comparing the number which is generated by the random function with the values, with the integer number. And for each integer from 1 to 9, we have a predefined, you can say, a message or a predefined statement which will be outputted. So depending on what number the random function gives us randomly, we will compare that particular number and we will see what message. These are just a random messages. There is no actual meaning to it. These are just random text messages which we have supplying it to every if else statements, if else clause, you can say. So for every number, the basic whole idea here is that for every number, there is a message, predefined message. And what we are doing is we are comparing that randomly generated number with our list of numbers. And then we are printing a specific message corresponding to that particular number. Right. So how do we do that? We are making use of this function getAnswer. So depending on whatever number the random function generates, we will be printing some statement, some message. Once, outside this function, what we are going to do is we are going to call that random function. And we have already discussed how do we call a particular function from a particular module. We first call that name of the module, followed by a dot, then followed by the particular function under that module, right? So name of the module is random and the function name is randint. So the way to invoke that function is random.randint. And inside that function, we are passing the argument. So as you so far you must be knowing, these values are nothing but the start and the stop value, or the bracket values, you can say, the limit values. So it will start from 1 and went down to value 9. So random int function will generate numbers randomly from in between from 1 to 9, right? So now this, whatever the number is generated by this random integer function, let's say it generates 5, that 5 will be assigned to a variable r, right? And that r, what we're going to do is we are going to give this value r to our getAnswer function as the parameter. So once that 5 is here, we have that 5 in the answer number, then the if else condition keeps, we get inside the function and every conditional statement is checked unless we encounter the answer number exactly equal to 5. And then we print the subsequent message that is corresponding to that particular number, right? So after that, once we are out of this, when we, the message that we get, the output, right? Once we are out of this function, the return value, now keep, focus here, the most important factor here is the return value of the function, right? The return value of this function getAnswer will be stored in another variable. Let's say it has been named as fortune, right? So we'll see what exactly are we printing, because we are unaware what will be returned by this function. We know what is what can be the possible values for this random integer function. A particular number will be randomly generated and that particular number will be compared with these if else statements and corresponding state printf statement will be the message will be printed. But we don't know, for time being, we don't know what value will be returned by this function, right? So far you must already be knowing, or you must be already aware, that every function returns something, right? If when we make use of when we define a function and when we call the function in, let's say, in our main function, we return a particular value, return 1 or return 0, anything, right? So that depends, but every function returns some value. So we will see what our function getAnswer will return us. So just to record that return value, we will have another variable, let's say fortune, which will store the value returned by the function getAnswer and will ultimately print that fortune value or the returned value stored in the fortune. So that we'll see what is the output, what is the return value. So let me execute this by first saving the function, and I'll save it as, let's say, let me give the same name so that it will be easier for us to refer back. Right. So the program name that I'm mentioning here is the Magic 8 Ball. So as you can see, let me exit this whole thing and do a fresh execution. So as you can see, the value that I'm getting here is concentrate and ask again. So I don't know what value the random integer function has generated, right? And how are we comparing it? So when I execute it once again, let me execute it once again. So what it is doing, it is giving me the same set of you can say the values, the message, right? It is giving me the value, the number which is getting generated is 6, and concentrate and ask again is what I'm getting, right? Let me execute once again, and now it says yes, just yes, right? So yes was corresponding to a number 3, right? So random function has this time generated number 3. It has compared this elif statement with the number 3. When it has found true, it has returned the value yes. And then the return value, this return value yes, is getting stored in the fortune, right? Because the return value which the value that we are getting returned from the function get answer is getting stored in the variable fortune and ultimately is printed, right? So let's say if we want to print the variable, the number which has been generated by random int, what we'll do is we'll just print r. Let me save the function again and run the program once again. Now you can see that it is also printing with the value here. Let me clear this off and execute once again. So as you can see, it is printing the value of r, that is the randomly generated number by the rand int function, and at the same time it is giving me the corresponding statement inside that number r, right? Which is outlook not so good, it's a random message. So let me go back to the program and see for number 8, it is outlook not so good. So let me execute it once again and see what can be the output. So these are the randomly generated number, which might be sometimes same, which might be different. So here, as you can see, number 6 is concentrate and ask. So I hope you got the point here. So let me remove this thing back and give it again. Right. So what is happening here is, as I mentioned, we are making use of the random function, which is an inbuilt function. But at the same time, we are defining our own function by using a keyword def, and get answer is our main is our defined function. Inside this function, we are passing a parameter, a value. Now this value is actually, which is the randomly generated number from 1 to 9. Now whatever that value will be in between 1 to 9 will be compared with all the if else statements here. And once the statement is true for that particular number, the returned, the statement or the print, the message that we are giving will be returned, and that return value, this is the return value of get answer function, is stored in another variable for fortune. This was just for our reference to give us the output, what exactly is the random value generated by the random function. So I hope you got the point here. The intention of showing you this program as to how, whatever we have discussed so far, how do we import a random function, how can we define a function, how can we pass the argument, how can we make use of conditional statements, if, else, elif and all, right? So these things, I think these are basic few things which has to be understood, right? Any doubt so far before proceeding ahead, anything, any doubt? Okay, says no doubt. Anushka says, is randit a built-in function present in the random? Yeah, I think you missed out our previous class. In the previous class, we discussed about the module and the inbuilt function inside modules. So randint is actually an inbuilt function, which is inside the standard library module random. So in order to make use of this random randint inbuilt function, we have to import this module random. So I'm going pretty slow just to make sure that you guys are understanding. So, but still, in case if you have any doubt, you can stop me anytime and you can ask your doubts. Similar doubt can have with somebody else. So if there are no doubts, let us move ahead. Now, one more thing, important thing is the exact statements what you wrote, what we wrote, that R is equal to rand dot randint 1,9 and then fortune is equal to get answer R, then print fortune. This all things can be done in a single line, which is can be called as an inline instruction, which is nothing but printing the value that is generated by the randint function and which is passed as the argument or the parameter to the function get answer. And in turn, whatever the return value of this get answer function will be printed by the printf statement. So whatever we have achieved so far with these three statements can be reduced by using this only one statement, which is an inline statement, inline expression, which performs all these three tasks. It's a simple programming practice, which you might have already done in your C programming, I guess. Right. So moving ahead, we have the none values, as we have in our other programming languages, which are the none values, which are sometimes called as null or nil. And here it might sometimes can be also referred as unidentified. So simple program is, as I mentioned, as it is mentioned here, that spam is equal to print hello, what we discussed in our first two classes. Spam is equal to print hello. So what it is doing is, once we execute this program, the print statement, the print function, pardon me, the print function prints the expression or the string which we have passed as the argument to the print function, which is hello. And then what we are doing is, we are comparing the none value, this none value, to this variable spam. Right. Now you can see here the none is equal to spam is a comparison, right? If it is exactly equal to spam. Now none is equal to spam has been true, because the reason being, once this printf statement get executed, the printf statement, the print function, the print function returns a value, some value to the variable spam. Now by default, that this value will be a null value, right? Once this print function gets executed, it returns a null value to the assigning variable. Now the assigning variable here is a spam. Now when we compare none is equal to spam, which actually spam doesn't contain anything which is actually a null value, right? So none is equal to none, which is true, and hence we get the value true at the in the shell, in the interactive shell, right? So it's a simple implementation of how a null can be compared, and it is a simple demonstration of how functions, after getting executed, what do they return to the assigning variable, or even if they are not assigning, what do they return to the parent function, you can say. So the argument that we pass here, let us understand more about it, how a keyword argument, for example here the print hello, what we discussed in our initial classes, print hello and print world, it's a simple statement. Now the same function, if we don't want to make this print on the next line, let's say we want to make it print on the same line in the continuous fashion, so we can pass another parameter to the function, which is called end, and end has been assigned with a blank string, a simple single quote, open and close single quote characters, right? So print function has two parameters now. First is the string itself, the message that we want to convey, the hello. Separated by a comma, we have another variable called end, which has nothing into it, which is blank, right? So, and after this function gets executed, this print function gets executed, we have another print function called world. Now, when we execute this program, the output that we see is hello world in continuous fashion, instead of hello world getting printed on new line. The reason being is the there is no new line printed after this hello program, right? The new line is not printed. It is ended here exactly where the hello is printed, and the next print statement starts execution right from here because of this end what we have given, right? So this is useful if you need to, you know, if you don't want that new line or you don't want to make use of the new line by default new line function. You want to disable that new line, right? Mm-hmm. Which by default get added anyhow in the print function. So I hope you got it. So similar case, you can see here print cat, dog, mice. So what it is doing it, it is simply printing it in a state line. But if you do it in three different printf statements, it will show you on the next line, three new lines. So I think, okay, so local and global scope, we shall continue in our next class because we are about to elapse the time. So far, anybody having any kind of doubt with respect to whatever we have discussed? Or everything is crystal clear? I'm going very slow because these are very fundamental. So if you don't know these things, the further programs will not be, you know, understood by you. So those who are done something with respect to Python, doing some kind of project or work, for them it will be a simple cakewalk. But those who are new to the Python, considering those people in mind, the speed of this explanation is what I have reduced because I want everybody to be on the same platform. But still, if you have any kind of doubt, any query, you can stop me anytime in between, you can ask. Yeah, please, the session is open for 2 minutes for the question answer session if you have any queries. Let me know at least if you have queries, or even if you don't have any queries, let me know. Everything is clear. Please, you guys don't respond here. I don't know why. Anybody having any kind of doubt? So I hope you are working on your assignment. So to avoid end moment rush, I would say you keep a note of whatever we discuss here in class on daily basis. You can make notes on daily basis so that you reduce your piled up work. Even if you keep making notes here in the class when we are discussing the things, only thing that you have to do when you come back is you have to submit. That's it. You will not be having any pending work or piled up work at the end, right? So let's say I'm thinking of having a kind of quiz, maybe once we finish this module. We are about to finish this module, maybe in our one or maybe maximum two lectures, this module will be finished. So maybe after that we'll have a quiz. Let's see whether you have really understood or I'm addressing a sleeping crowd. I can find that very few people who are active, these are the fixed faces, the known faces which are answering. But I'm very much worried about the other guys who are not opening up, not interacting. And I don't know whether they are even mentally present or no. Anyways, so if there are no doubts, we'll conclude the lecture. And if you still have any doubts, you can contact anywhere, WhatsApp or Google Classroom. For time being, let us stop here, and you have another class to join. You can leave from this meeting. Thank you.